Guys, we are on a call where it's one of my first installations. So it's about 8-9 years old. I guess I've been in business 11 years now. So within the first couple of years of us opening the business, we installed this one. So let's go see what's going on. Okay, she's been likely freezing up.
I know last time you was here, you were saying that it was under warranty, probably had another one tearing up.
Okay, I'm gonna turn it on and see what happens, okay?
Okay,
that motor does not sound good.
So that motor don't sound good.
Okay, that blower sounded horrible. Looks like I put that in with no disconnect. I want to try to at least see if it's cooling. I think that motor's been stopping. Got spiders everywhere. Off. Come on.
Wait a minute.
They got problems other than that blower motor. That head pressure looks about normal, but that suction does not. This is a 410 system. Cooling. That can't be right. Low subcooling, and it looks like really high superheat. Try to hold that where y'all can see it. This thing's low on refrigerant. Plus, that blower motor sounds horrible. Alright. We're going to have to do a leak search. Bearings on that seemed a little stiff. I'm not seeing any obvious oil spots in here. Let's start inside. All right, we're back inside and we killed power. Piston. Let's do a leak search. Still some ice in here. Y'all see that? That went up to 21. Let's watch that zero a little bit. Just zeroed. That's all I need to see. Well, you got a leak in here.
Yeah, I knew that. I don't know why I put the pot down there.
All right, so I originally thought that blower motor was the reason it had been icing up. That was not it at all. But I am giving her a quote to replace blower motor and evaporator coil, plus do a coil cleaning outside. This lady may be under the impression that everything is under warranty, so I've got to tell her that's not the case, just the parts, and tell her that she ain't gonna have any air until maybe Wednesday of next week. So I got to deliver double bad news. Okay, so she was not happy, but she knows she's got to have air. So today is Thursday. She's not going to have air until Wednesday of next week at the earliest. While I've got y'all's attention, I was wanting to discuss something that has started to become a problem here in Georgia. The DOE is making changes that take effect January 1st of next year, one of which is the refrigerant. The SEER ratings are going up by one. So if you're in the north and you've been able to buy the field charged R22-13 SEER condensers, that's coming to an end in January. That came to an end for us back in 2015. So we're going up to 15 SEER. Up north, you're going up to 14 SEER. But another thing that's happening is they basically aren't letting us buy straight cool condensers anymore. If it's a split system, I mean, already it has to be a heat pump because electric heat cannot be the primary source of heat here in Georgia. But now, if you want to buy a condenser and case coil to put on a furnace, you have to buy a heat pump starting January. And all of our suppliers have seen this coming, and they've stopped ordering the straight cool condensers because they can't sell them come January 1st. So straight cool condensers right now are becoming really hard to find. And it sounds like they want us to make every furnace, a split furnace, a dual fuel. I mean, it's not really going to add a whole lot to the cost, but ripping out a furnace coil and condenser, and I've got to make that kind of upgrade, I would seriously consider just putting in a heat pump and be done with the furnace. Down here, it don't get very cold. We have very few days below freezing. We might have maybe 10 days where the morning is below freezing, but by afternoon we're wearing a t-shirt. And I don't know, some of these higher sear heat pumps can produce heat all the way down to 0 degrees. But anyway, if y'all are experiencing some of the same effects from this new Department of Energy regulations that are just cold stopping the straight coal condensers come January, comment below. Or if you're in another part of the country that's having different kinds of regulations, I'd like to know what those are, because I read the basic information on the updates that are coming January 1st, and what I read didn't mention anything about not being able to install straight cool condensers anymore. But that's going to be the case. So it looks like I'm going to be doing some dual fuels. And down here that just seems ridiculous, because a dual fuel is not, it don't make a whole lot of sense. They don't get that cold. If you're going to do a dual fuel, you might as well just do a heat pump. Thanks for watching, guys. I'll catch y'all on the next one.